Welcome everyone to the Inside Java Newscast, where we cover recent developments in the OpenJDK community. I'm Nikolai Parlock, Java developer advocate at Oracle, and while I'm notoriously excited about every new Java feature, I'm particularly thrilled about this one. Most of us have been using the Stream API for almost a decade now, and while it works great, there are quite a few intermediate operations that I miss day to day. Windowing, folding, subsequencing. So what's the news? We're going to get all those operations? Yes and no. Or rather, no, but yes. Let me explain. JDK Enhancement Proposal 461 proposes an intermediate meta operation that allows the JDK and us to implement all kinds of intermediate operations without directly overloading the stream interface. This new API is to intermediate operations what collectors are to terminal operations, and the name is similar too. We're talking about gatherers. Let's dive right in. A gatherer consists of four functions, and we'll go through them one by one with some examples to see what the tasks are. But before we start, let's quickly rehash some terminology. A stream pipeline starts with a source, like calling stream on a list, followed by a number of intermediate operations, those are the methods that return a stream, and finally, a terminal operation like toList or the more general collect. Source, intermediate, terminal operations, they're all stages in such a stream pipeline, and the elements that come from the source are transformed, filtered, etc. from one stage to the next. Now, JEP 461 proposes to add a new intermediate operation, gather, that accepts a gatherer and returns a transformed stream. Let's talk about the four functions that make it work. We start with the integrator. This is the main function that consumes and emits elements. Its input is a state, more on that in a minute, an element from the previous stage, and an instance of type downstream that can be used to emit elements to the next stage. Its Boolean return value signals whether it wants to process more elements after the current one. The simplest possible integrator does nothing and just passes each element on. To do that on each call, it takes the element that's passed to it, calls downstream push with it, and then returns true to signal that more elements can be processed. Other simple intermediate operations are map and filter, which we can re-implement as gatherers. The integrator for a map takes the input element, applies the mapping function, and passes the new element downstream. The integrator for a filter takes the input element, applies the predicate, and if it returns true, passes the element on. Otherwise, it does nothing with it. Both integrators always return true because they'll never stop processing elements. Now, let's do something more interesting and implement a stateful operation. A stateful operation is one that creates and updates state. Shocking, I know. These two aspects, creation and updates, are executed by two different functions. Creation is the task of the initializer, which is just a fancy name for a supplier. It is called before the first element is processed to create the initial state instance. State updates happen during integration. Remember a minute ago when I said that a state is passed to the integrator? That happens so it can read and potentially mutate it. Let's re-implement the stream operation limit with that. It needs to keep track of how many elements it has already seen, so we'll need a mutable counter. Atomic integer fits the bill. So our initializer returns a new instance of atomic integer starting with value 0. The stream API will then pass that instance to our integrator, which gets the integer, interpreting it as the current element's index before incrementing it. A simple comparison of that index with the integer passed to our limit informs our integrator whether it wants to pass the element on. Done. Or are we? What should the integrator return? If it's always true, it will consume the entire stream. That's technically correct, but wasteful for finite streams and a big problem for infinite streams. So this is the first example where the integrator returns false, namely when the next element would be beyond the limit. Another stateful operation, and arguably a cooler one, only emits elements that are larger by a given comparator than all the elements seen previously. This transforms a sequence into an increasing subsequence. So for example, 1, 3, 2, 5, 1 gets turned into 1, 3, 5. To implement this, the initializer returns an empty atomic reference as initial state. The integrator then uses the comparator to figure out whether the current element is larger than the one in the state, and if so, emits it and writes it to the state object, otherwise it ignores it. And it always returns true to continue processing the stream, because you never know whether a later element won't be larger. But what if we need to do something after the last element, some kind of final operation? That's where the third function, the finalizer, comes in. Nikolai from editing here. Not sure why I call them finalizers, they're called finishers. After our gatherer is done integrating, it will get one final chance to emit elements. To that end, the state and downstream are passed to the finalizer function, which can emit more elements as it sees fit. One example operation where this comes in real handy is a grouping function that transforms a stream of elements into a stream of groups of elements. In such cases, you usually only emit a group once it's completed. But when you're processing the stream's last element, you don't know that you need to complete the current group, and if you don't, the last group is missing. A simple example of this is an operation that emits groups of fixed size, which is given as a parameter. The initializer creates an empty array list as state, and the integrator adds the element to the list and, if it reached the desired size, emits a copy of it before clearing the list. You can see how this can leave the last group hanging if the last element didn't happen to complete it. So our finalizer just takes that list and, if it's not empty, emits it to make sure that the last couple of elements show up in a group in a downstream stage. A more interesting example would be to turn our increasing subsequence operation into one that emits portions of the original sequence that are increasing. So 1, 3, 2, 5, 1 gets turned into 1, 3, 2, 5, 1. I'll leave that as an exercise to you. Or, if you're lazy, check out the video I published on my private channel where I implement all gatherer examples given here and a few more. The last of the four operations is the combiner. It's only needed for parallel streams, but oh, would you look at that? It's already way past bedtime for me, so I'll leave this not-trivial topic to the eventual JEP Café. So JEP 461 proposes stream gather, the gatherer interface, and a few more type that needs. It is not currently targeted to any release, but I hope that it previews in 2024, ideally in JDK 22. Once the feature is final, we get the capability to express all kinds of intermediate operations by implementing them as a gatherer and passing it to stream gather. The easiest way to share them is to add the factory method that creates them to some utility class. In fact, that's exactly what JEP 461 proposes, because it also comes with the gatherers class, plural, again much like collectors, that contains operations like folding, scanning, sliding windows, and a concurrent map that spawns a virtual thread for each application of the mapping function. Check out more about all that in the JEP that is of course linked in the description. And one more thing before I let you go. If you're using Visual Studio Code, VS Code, whether as a new Java developer, for experiments with new Java features, or for work on regular projects, you should absolutely try out the new Oracle Java extension. It has a few cool perks over the default Java extension. It's based on Java C for earlier support of new versions like 21 right now and soon 22 EA. It has better Gradle integration, and it's overall a much smoother development experience. I leave a few links related to the extension in the description right under the like button, which, you know, you could press if you check them out. That helps the channel and lets more Java developers know about gatherers, which spares you from having to explain it to them. Win-win. Also, subscribe, and I'll see you again in 2 weeks. So long!